served as the executive director of the one-of-a-kind state agency, the Oklahoma Commission on Marginally Producing Oil and Gas Wells. I understand the unique parameters of an agency and its duties. Oklahoma is considered a mature oil-producing state, however, we are the third largest producer of natural gas in the U.S. Marginal Well Commission monitored and producers provided education and did our best to save as many well bores as possible. Before you view the issue of hydraulic fracturing, in many cases, populations have encroached upon existing production. An issue for the mineral and royalty owner is a potential condemnation of their real property rights. By prohibiting the development of natural resources, in many today's newly discovered shale plays, the local residents are not aware of the established law of dominant estate. The mineral ingress and egress that accompany the mineral rights must carry the highest priority. If you look around the Barnett Shale, you will see this very problem at play. Restrictions that would prohibit hydraulic fracturing would in fact be a dangerous movement of these private rights of ingress and egress from the property line to 10,000 feet below the surface where the natural resources exist. Oklahoma has over 400,000 well bores and still has 150,000 producing wells that have virtually all been stimulated. Even with our long history of oil and gas production, the state's most coveted asset is our clean water. I hope the committee will consider the American Well Council as a resource. There are wealthy owners there.
Thank you very much. Mr. Vigorello from Tipperary.
I represent the Texas Independent Producers and Royalty Owners Association, also known as TIPRO. In 2009, Texas producers provided roughly 12% of Texas employment, which equates to about 1.3 million jobs. They spend billions of dollars annually to protect the environment, at the same time provide clean, abundant, and affordable energy supplies to power our nation's economy and reduce our reliance on foreign sources. The enormous amounts of energy reserves in shale formations cannot be produced without the use of horizontal drilling and hydraulic fracturing. These new technologies have resulted in plentiful supplies of gas to keep the price low and make the cost of heating and cooling Americans' homes affordable. TIPRO is very supportive of the study to evaluate the concerns associated with hydraulic fracturing. We are confident, however, that the findings will show that adequate regulations already exist at the state level to protect usable groundwater from all oil and gas activities, including hydraulic. We would caution, however, that the study be conducted by qualified people using scientific principles and factual data, not based on political or philosophical assertions. Hydraulic fracturing has been used routinely and safely since the 1940s in more than a million wells in the United States. As former executive director of the Railroad Commission, I can attest that protection of freshwater aquifers throughout state for proper well bore construction is one of the agency's primary regulatory functions and one that receives the highest priority. While this focus and emphasis needs to continue, we do not believe that additional layers of regulation will result in better protection of natural resources. Thank you.
Quiet speaker, Mr. John Rapp, who owns Dar Chapters here.
Dr. Armendariz is an EPA official. On behalf of the 21,000 people I'm representing, 7,000 of which live in Dallas and Fort Worth, a huge thank you for being here. You asked for priorities. I've got three. First of all, this study needs to be broad, very broad. It needs to include the entire life cycle of the process, from before the drill bit hits the ground until well after it's taken out. Number two, I appreciate your sense of urgency and thoroughness on this, but right now, I think you've got enough data to regulate this process even before the study is concluded, and I'd ask you to please consider that. I'm all in favor of your case study approach because we do need on-the-ground field research. There are different applications in different parts of the country, and it requires people to be there taking data on the ground. Again, thank you very much.
If you have wristbands with the numbers 26 through 50, if you collect by that back door, Nora will meet you there. I will use this opportunity too while I have the floor back door. To say that we have approximately 85 more speakers in Everybody takes 2 minutes, that's almost 3 hours. We're only here for another 2 hours and 20 minutes. So every time we have the clapping and everything else, it just slows it down. And I guarantee that those people who are at the tail end of that will be able to speak. So I urge you to just refrain from doing that. EPA needs to hear from as many of you as possible. With that, let's call number speaker 21, Mr. Jerry Baker from the IOGCC.
In the spirit of that, sir, thank you. I'll keep my remarks quite brief. I do represent the governors of the 38 oil and gas producing states, or our organization does. I just want to remind the US EPA that the states do regulate hydraulic fracturing. They, and the potential and protection of the potential sources of drinking water is an uncompromised critical function of state government officials. I'd like to encourage US EPA to tap into resources that the states have been, the data that the states have been developing for the last 50 plus years, and we are looking forward to being cooperative with you. I'd like for you to reach out to us through our governor's offices, through our oil and gas directors. And finally, to say that if any of you have reported, you know, problems with your groundwater contamination suspected, report it to your state oil and gas officials. They will want to investigate that because that is their job. That's all I have to say. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Next to the podium is Doreen Geiger.
Thank you. On the campus of the University of Texas at Arlington, there is a drill site currently with 22 gas wells. The site is adjacent to a child development center that's on campus that serves 119 children each day, ages 6 weeks through 5 years. This site where the 22 wells are has a naturally occurring small creek that runs through it. And I just offer for a suggestion that one of the places you might consider including in your test might be the UTA site. They are currently finishing the fracturing of 8 of the last 8 wells. And since there may be some type of chemicals or runoff from that naturally occurring creek, that might be one place you might want to consider for the study. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Next, we have number 23, Ms. Stephanie Meadows from the Energy Petroleum Institute.
API has more than 400 member companies which represent all sectors of America's oil and natural gas industry. Our members have extensive experience with the drilling and completion techniques like hydraulic fracturing to safely and reasonably develop shale gas. This technology is crucial to gaining access to clean burning and domestically abundant natural gas, which will help meet energy needs for generations of Americans to come. Our top priority is to provide energy in a safe, technologically sound way with the least possible impact on the environment. Take seriously our responsibility to our members and surrounding communities to work in cooperation with federal and state governments to develop design standards, recommended practices, and guidance documents that will improve operational integrity and regulatory processes across the board. We know there has been substantial public concern over the use of hydraulic fracturing, and we support the EPA's ongoing scientific review of this technology and its potential impact on water resources. We plan to remain actively engaged in both the study plan development and its ultimate implementation. We are confident that a comprehensive review will confirm what 60 years of experience and investigation have demonstrated, that the sound application of this technology following well-recognized risk-based decision-making principles poses no significant risk to human health, drinking water resources, or the environment. API continues to develop additional guidance specific to this topic, including guidance on